pledge to the flag, pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All legislators should have received a copy of the September 1st and 14th business meeting. Does anyone have any corrections at this time? If not, they stand approved. Report the Rules and Legislation Committee per Rule 6. Carrie?
The Rules and Legislation Committee is met, and I recommend to waive the rules to act upon late resolutions.
Moved by Brian, second by Craig. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Oppose? Carrie? At this time, we'll open the public hearing for Local Law Number 6, which would allow us to authorize overriding the tax levy cap in the General Municipal Law for the Lewis County 2016 budget. Does anyone have any comments at this time regarding the public hearing? Okay, we'll come back to that later and offer it again. At this time, does anyone have anything for privilege of the floor? Moving along, presentation of communications and notices. Terry?
There's no correspondence.
Okay, reports of county officers and departments. Terry?
All legislators have received copies of the September Highway and Solid Waste Audit Reports, the Treasurer's Third Quarter Bed Tax and September Reports, and minutes of the August 18 Solon Water Board of Directors and the September 24 Youth Bureau Advisory Board meetings. Real Property Tax Director Linda Hoskins and Treasurer Patricia O'Brien have submitted approved applications for refund of 2013 and 2014 property taxes to Colleen Miller of Town of Watson in the amount of $267.16 and $271.59, respectively. The Board of Elections Commissioners has submitted the statements of canvass for the September 10 primaries to be placed on file, and the County Sealer of Weights and Measures, Barb Cooper, has submitted her third quarter report of activities that we placed on file. And these reports.
Thank you, Terry. Reports of the standing committees. Phil, Ways and Means, Buildings and Grounds.
Thank you. All our departments' 2015 budgets are on track. They're all comfortable and confident about it. The DSS parking lot, hopefully weather permitting, we will see big changes at the end of the week. They should be doing the top coat on it, on the majority of it. And that act also is within budget. Regarding solar, we are at the point now that further discussion needs to be an executive session, and we will do that today if permitted. And that's it.
Thank you, Phil. Neil, Social Service, House of the Agent.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Office of the Agent. Well, I'm not used to this microphone. Oktoberfest, an annual public picnic, was held on October 2nd. The event was successful with 166 participants. Community Service Needs Assessment Survey. If you haven't already done so, please take the survey, which will assist OFA in planning for the 2016 to 2020 period, a four-year period. Surveys can be completed through mid-October. Contact OFA if you need a survey. Request for a proposal, nutrition services program for congregate and home delivered meals being issued today, October 6th. Response is due no later than October 27th. Heat, early mail out of applications began August 24th. To date, 214 applications have been received at OFA office. The unofficial opening date for the program is November 16th. Once the New York State plan has been approved by the federal government, and we have permission to release the opening bid, and income guidelines outreach will commence. HICAP, better known as Health Insurance Information Counseling and Assistance Program. Annual coordinated open enrollment runs from October 15 through December 7 of each year. During this time period, Medicare beneficiaries are encouraged to review the current coverage to determine if any changes might be necessary for 2016. Beneficiaries request assistance with Part B prescription plans, Part C Medicare Advantage plans, retiree coverage, and also supplemental plans during this time period. Appointments must be made in advance. That's all I have for OFA. DSS, I apologize, Jen sent me highlights. However, my printer failed me today, so I didn't bring it with me. However, I'd like to make a motion to authorize the Commissioner Jennifer Jones to refill an existing community service worker's position upon the pending resignation of the current employee.
Okay, motion made by Neil, second by Andrea. Discussion? All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion is carried.
The Youth Bureau, I also had a problem with the printer, but I believe they had a meeting this past Thursday. They discussed the National Night Out, which was a success as well. And they are now entertaining applications for the money that they receive from the state. I believe it's like $13,000 that they could give out to organizations that do things for the youth in the community. So thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Very good, Neil. Thank you. Ryan, County Officers, Veteran, Junkyard, H&R.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Junkyard, we had five people that were in violation. There's been an attempt to reach one person that is going to go on to be handled through a court order. We had two junkyard renewals granted, two denied, one just for a minor thing, just for a fence waiver needs to be signed, the other because of a law change in the town that it's in. Veterans, Derek didn't have any numbers for us, so we really didn't have anything from veterans. He had worked on the budget at that time. HR, we listened to requests for positions to be filled, which you're going to have resolutions for them each tonight, one for jail nurse, one for temp full-time and probation, part-time dispatcher, correction officer, and the person that Neil just spoke of. And that's all I have, Mr. Chairman.
Very good, Brian. Jerry, courts and law.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Bring you up to date a little bit on the radio system. Pagers for Lewis, Carthage, and Harrisville. What we've been doing is preliminary testing by putting the other frequencies in. Harrisville tones off of St. Lawrence, Jefferson County for Carthage, and Oneida County for Lewis. Lewis has done theirs, and it's worked where we can use the same pager for both. We sent them back to Harrisville to try testing again. So what it's going to do is everybody, if it works, everybody's going to get it over one pager. We'll be able to, it'll make life simpler. The antenna for Krogan arrived last Friday. They were supposed to have it up Monday. My understanding, if Johnson, some of them arrived yesterday to start the initial testing after the new antenna. So they'll be doing in-house testing this week. Next week, there's going to be some training held here. I believe it's for dispatch this week. EF Johnson's techs trained Wells Communication in some of the procedures. I don't know if Adam had time or not, just to kind of set in. He was able to do that over the web, just to get an understanding. We have automatic transfer switch. Cummings been here, tested the switches and the generators. Everything worked fine, except we have four automatic transfer switches that are not engaging the way they should. When we bought the equipment shelters, they were put in the equipment shelters, so Bob Duclos has contacted somebody to get a date when they can fly out here and look at the switches. Let me see what else. We're still waiting. We're following up on that. We've had some trouble with some of the locks on the equipment shelters. They kind of seem to be in a bind, so they're getting a hold of the shelter manufacturer or the lock, whatever type of lock it was represented. Come out and look at those and take care of that. Dog control officer, we're getting close. The only thing we're waiting on, Jefferson County had some information. I don't know if that's made it in yet or not. So we wanted to check that, and we'll present our decision to you hopefully next week or next month, because we got a budget. If we do something, it's got to be figured in there too. So thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Very good, Jerry. Any questions for Jerry? We're getting close to that radio project. Dick?
Good.
Bill?
I'm good, Dick. Jerry, on the North South Central grant that the fire department's in after, is there any update on any of that yet? Is that still?
We haven't heard anything, you know. We've tried to get some other people involved and it hasn't come out.
So still processing?
Well, supposedly, yeah, so. Hopefully.
Bill?
My question.
Got it answered. Any other questions? Thank you, Jerry. Larry, Economic Development Insurance Forestry.
I'll start with Frank in planning asked me to mention our stream gauge program is up and running. Data is being collected and shared with Hudson River, Hudson Black River Regulating District, Jefferson County Soil and Water, and the public. We will be installing visual monitoring locations during the month of November through 15 along Ridge Road, Mertz, East Martinsburg, and Water Street, weather permitting. From Parks and Rec, I might make a motion to authorize Recreation, Forestry, and Parks Director Jacqueline Mahoney to travel to the Garden State Outdoor Sportsman Show in Edison, New Jersey from January 6th to January 11th, 2016. Tri-State Outdoor Expo in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania from January 28th to February 1st, 2016. And Springfield Camp and Outdoor Show in Springfield, Massachusetts from February 12th to February 13th, 2016.
Okay, we have a motion by Larry. Do we have a second? Second by Craig. Discussion. Jerry.
Yeah, on the gauges we have for the streams, how are we going to monitor those? Who's going to do it when, you know, we're having the runoff and stuff like that?
Well, the ones that are installed now are in soil, the gauges are in soil and water, and the Shell is monitoring them. Frank, do you want to talk a little bit about the ones that you're...
Yes, I can. Basically, the system is, it's a live system. The base unit that each of the units talk to is positioned in Michelle's office, the soil and water conservation. And the system, it's an electronic system, so we have it programmed for specific levels. So we have these alarms that go off and they automatically call us if in fact we reach a certain level that we need to start monitoring on a much closer basis. So those three units are in place, and actually last week with the water that we, some of the precipitation that we had, we were able to actually see the interaction with the gauges with the closest USGS gauge, which is in Boonville. And the systems reacted and worked perfectly, so.
But, I mean, if you got, and I'm just asking, because like soil and water, they go home at night. Do you have an alarm? It dials your phone, say we had one heck of an increase?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, the system, we can program into the system level alarms. So what we have a minor warning alarm, and then we have major. So as soon as it hits that alarm level, it automatically dials and it will call it will call several people. It'll call Michelle first. She's the primary on it. So we get those notifications immediately.
Okay, because we got the notifications with the radio system that we can send warnings out to. Thank you.
Frank, included in that call list, is it the 911 center also included?
Yes, we actually, well, what we did is we just had a meeting yesterday with emergency management with Bob McKenzie. And Bob, Michelle Ledoux, and myself, and we're putting together a protocol that we're going to be able to follow now that we have this new program in place. Something else that's actually just coming to fruition, we're waiting for the final approval from it. But when we met last week with the regulating district, they were very interested that we had these three positions in place along the Black River. So, it actually, one that we'll be installing along the Beaver. And they made a proposal to us that they were going to go to their board, and if in fact their board approved it, they would put a satellite link up on our building where Michelle's office is, and our data would actually be live on the USGS website. So we would have more data points in this area that would be accessible immediately. And what that would do is that would also allow the regulating district to monitor more closely as they're regulating the flows coming out of their reservoirs. So we're hopeful that their board is going to agree with their thought process, and if so, they're the ones that will install the satellite link, and they will maintenance the satellite link at roughly a tune of about $7,800 a year. So it's invaluable information once you get these systems up and running, because basically the water doesn't stop at our boundaries, so it kind of helps everyone as we put these programs together.
Thank you.
Okay, we have a motion on the floor that would allow our trail coordinator, Jackie Mahoney, to attend various shows outside the state. Is there any discussion on that motion? Dick?
Yeah, Larry, the trips that you mentioned in your motion are the same trips that were taken this year, for the most part? No.
Jack, do you want to speak to them?
We changed some things around. These are only the out-of-state trips. Last year we had gone to Ohio and Erie, Pennsylvania. This year we switched it to the Pittsburgh show in Pennsylvania, and we're trying New Jersey.
Okay, and then my last question is, the cost for those will be in the...
It comes out of the chamber budget.
Very good. Thank you. That's all I got.
Any other questions or comments on the motion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Does the bail money come out of your budget?
You're on the short dial list.
Oh boy.
Back to you, Larry.
Okay, economic development. Regional council report for the annual process is complete and will be submitted to New York State. The URI report preparation has been in full swing the last 2 weeks and will be completed by September 28th. Incubator building, we are actively working on this project with potential location in an existing facility as the primary focus. This building has significant square footage, and we will be looking into the cost for lease or to purchase, and also looking at the potential for utilization for office space as well as incubator space. We are still in discussion with two potential tenants. The IDA has hired Tim Peterson as a business development specialist. Tim started at 20 hours per week in early September and is working at Incubator Business Park and developing a site inventory. Lewis County Development Corp. Demolition work is ongoing at the Lions Falls Mill site. The LDC has received $500,000 recently from New York State for a past due grant request, and has also been approved for a line of credit through DANC for construction financing. At this point, funding for the current project should be secured, and new funding will be needed to be sought for the next phase of demolition. From insurance, there is a resolution in tonight's packet to increase the health insurance premium 15%. We have no choice in this, as the union defeated the concept of any changes to the plan. This is unfortunate, and that creates a burden not only to the employees, but to the county as well. The decision was necessary due to the health insurance fund balance, which is used to pay the monthly bills, has diminished to the point where there is barely enough cash to cover the bills as they come in. It's important to note that we are not on a sustainable path with our health insurance plan. The model is broken, and we are simply, again, kicking the can down the road. And that's the end of my report, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you for the bleak report, Larry. Craig, transportation, solid waste.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First off, I want to let you know that we have postponed the BC and engineering at the transfer site. We had engaged them to look at modernization or efficiencies there for waste management. And in the interim, Dank has received a grant to do that same exact thing, basically, for the entire Tri-County area. So we postponed doing anything further on that until such time as Dank completes their study and provides us with those results. We didn't feel it necessary to duplicate the effort. We also authorized Pete to any equipment that is being surplus, he can put on the Teetsworth site, and that it can be bid on through the internet. This has worked out well for him in the past, and he'd like to continue to do it. We also authorize the placement of an ad campaign that's being worked on now to educate the residents of Lewis County on recycling. Primarily, we're trying to let them know what type of things we would expect in the recycling bins as opposed to going right into the landfills. This also, we hope to address the clear bag issue. I brought a couple of samples. I don't know if it's necessary to show them, but I do have them if anybody's interested. They are available through Target, allegedly through Walmart, although locally I haven't seen them. I buy mine and have for a number of years from Sam's Club, and they range from 5 gallon to 55 gallon in various weights, so they are available. So we discussed as a committee the concept of the solid waste facility possibly in the interim until there's an abundant supply at the local retailers, making them available to our customers. They go up to solid waste. We aren't trying to start a new business here. We're just trying to mitigate until such times as local stores get the product in.
When's that effective?
March 1st. That's all I have for the transfer site. On the highway end, the Van Aber Bridge will be completed by the 13th. They will not open until the 16th because they still have to get the guide rails put in, and that's an out-of-town company comes in and does that. But they fully anticipate by the 16th of this month that'll be fully operational. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Frank Archer and his crew. I don't know if any of you would have recently been down to the highway department. Frank's crew has done an awful lot to spruce it up, if you will, painting, trim, new signage. Actually, it looks very, very nice, and they work very hard, and I want to thank them. And that's all I have, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Very good, Greg. Greg, taxation, elections, IT.
Thanks, Mr. Chairman. We had a very short and brief meeting. The IT department was the only one there. Linda was out, and so was the elections. Adam and Joan are working on the agreement for the Mohawk Networks for the broadband pilot project, and they're putting together the legal documentation for that. Adam also was looking at taking advantage of broadband grant monies offered by the governor, explained that intermapper would provide real-time monitoring of the entire software equipment network for 24/7 alerts. That way he could pinpoint where issues were, where trouble issues were, and that way he could send people directly to that spot. Also, there's a resolution in here for putting a posting in the tax bill so that people can see where their money's going from our county taxes. And I think that's a really good idea because I don't think a lot of people understand how much money is actually going to state mandated project money. And that's all I have for you. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. Dick Hospital.
Yes. Last night, Monday, October 5th, the medical staff met to discuss their participation in the hospital's long-range strategic plan. Board of managers were invited to attend. I attended. As one might imagine, it was a spirited conversation. I thought it was a good conversation. Way too much for one night, so I'm sure there's going to be another one because we didn't get halfway through the handout that they handed out. But it was a very good start. We had the American Academy of Sleep Medicine on site September 25th to survey the sleep lab. They're very impressed. They're going to be recommending full AASM accreditation to include home sleep apnea, and they said they were very impressed with our program. Mr. Birch met with the Falls Pharmacy regarding their interest in rejoining the 340B program, and they will do that in January of 2016. This gives the hospital money for people who get prescriptions filled at the Falls Pharmacy, and it will help out with our bottom line. Mr. Birch also reported that he's working with the partners regarding DISRUP. The funds flow meetings continue. The next committee meeting for that is scheduled for Thursday, October 8th. And New York State DOH hopes to announce projects that will be awarded on October 20th. Our facility has three projects: the assisted living facility, Copenhagen Health Collaborative with the school, and surgical services renovation. From the finance side, there was a gain of $19,856 versus a budgeted loss of $204,691. The year-to-date gain is $634,398 versus a budgeted surplus of $404,752. The liability of the county totals $3.9 million as of September 18th, and Mr. Hellinger added that we're continuing to make our county's payments on time and per the agreement. The left without being seen numbers at the ER continue to decline. There were 6 in the month of August versus 27 in August a year ago. The BAP transformation plan was submitted to the state, and they have come back with additional questions, which we're answering. To date, the facility has received $4 million from the BAP program. Dr. John Leuenberger is very busy at the South Lewis Health Center. He's both family and neuromuscular medicine physician and being well received down there. Dr. Robert Swift, an orthopedic surgeon, is also continuing to be very busy, and he's adding another member to that for another week of representation here. The employee of the month was Phil Sweeney. He's part of the building maintenance program. He was thanked for all his help to both the residents up there and the medical staff and non-medical staff. You're going to see in your packet tonight a couple of positions. They're asking to create one full-time dietetic technician. That has a salary of $1,568 to $1,992, and they're going to abolish one registered dietitian card. The technician will actually save us quite a bit of money. You're going to ask to create another full-time ultrasound technician, this time with the word registered after it. That will allow us to put a person who was non-registered and now is registered into her proper work classification. Then we're going to abolish one full-time ultrasound technician non-registered position card, and we're going to abolish, or ask to abolish, one full-time quality assurance coordinator position card.
The net effect of this is positive on the budget. In other words, the budget will there'll be a decrease to budget expenses. Last but not least, the Lewis County Hospital Foundation's gala netted over $60,000 this year for that effort. Last year's was a little over $30,000, so unbelievable amount of increase in that. At the same time, we honored Dr. Domingo, who retired from Lewis County General Hospital after 40 years of service to our hospital. I ask everybody that sees her to congratulate her and thank her for her years of service and wish her well in retirement. That, except for questions, is my report.
Did you get the report from the guy that was doing the survey of the clinics and that type of thing? Has that come through yet?
That report's there, and it's going to be made available to the board a little later this month, yes.
Any other questions for Dick? Thank you, Dick. Andrea, Public Health and Community Service.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. For public health, I have two proclamations in our packet. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and also October 25th through October 31st is Lead Poisoning Prevention Week. The committee approved hiring a new temporary jail nurse, as a current nurse has resigned. Penny and Liz are researching the potential alternatives to cover this need. Bernie Bus Service is being recommended to provide preschool transportation as the bid was awarded based on being the lowest bid. Public Health is expecting to receive a Performance Initiative Award for STD disease control efforts in the amount of $13,000. A cost of living adjustment has been received, and most of it will be used to offset fringe costs. Penny is not expecting to replace any vehicles in 2016. Paula and Penny continue to work very hard on the 2016 budget. For the community services tonight, our new director, Patricia Freilich, is here. Would you like to stand up? And it's a joy to get to know her. I also want to thank Tammy McIntyre for all the work that she has done in the last few months at the Community Services Board. And that's it.
Thank you, Andrea. County Manager's Report. Liz, not ready.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to add one comment to Larry's about healthcare. I would say kicking the can down the road is an accurate assessment. We have not solved a very serious problem that we have with healthcare. However, the union has agreed to keep working with us to keep the issue alive and see what we can do to have more discussions with the employees. The other part of that program, even though the plan was voted down, employees did get a letter in their email and their mail regarding the new wellness program, Blue for You, which is available to all active county employees to basically get a blood draw that is confidential between them and their physician to analyze everyone for chronic diseases and heart issues and diabetes, things like that. The idea in a wellness program is to diagnose people early so they get the treatment they need, and obviously lower the catastrophic costs that could take place later on when people are not taking care of their health. So we're encouraging all employees to who have not done this on their own to please take care of it, because it is a program that we're offering at no cost to the employees. Other than healthcare, my month and Patty's month has been spent pulling together the 2016 budget. Good news, bad news story is we started when we first pulled the entire budget together with about an $800,000-$900,000 increase in the levy year over year. Through discussions, meetings we've had in the first go round with all the departments, that number is down to about a $440,000 increase. That's the increase right now in the levy over where it was in the 2015 budget. That is also about $300,000 over the tax cap if we decide to not maintain the tax cap. So we've got, Patty and I are meeting with the Ways and Means Committee tomorrow to give them some more of the nitty-gritty and the choices. Shortly after that, I expect I'll be in touch with all the board members either to convene some smaller meetings or get everybody back together so we can decide what the next choices may be for us. But I will say, I appreciate the fact that all the department heads, most of the department heads, have come in with some very strong ideas, some plans. Everybody's worked very hard to track their budgets year-round. I feel very comfortable that everyone is very fully aware of what's in their budgets, what kind of risks they can and cannot take going forward. So I think we'll end up with a good product, but we still got a ways to go. That's all I have right now, Mr. Chairman. Thank you.
Thank you, Liz. Patty, Treasurer's report.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just to give you a few balances. Special contingency has a balance of $92,859. Regular contingency has a balance of $291,210. Capital data processing has a balance of $141,722. Capital equipment, highway balance is $15,214. The county balance is $217,199. Sales tax figures, I don't have September's yet, but I am very confident that we will meet our budget this year. The hospital repayment, as Dick had mentioned, they are on time, and the remaining balance is $3.9 million. Internal service fund. Our fund balance is down to $1.5 million through August 31st. And our cash balance is at $1.7 million. Are there any questions? If not, I'm all set. Thank you.
Patty, any questions for Liz or Patty? Go ahead, Dick.
Yeah, Liz, and I don't know how much you can explain to this, but the health care issue, as I understood it, a lot of Eric from the hospital had talked to some of the, or all of the union people, probably through different meetings and stuff. And a lot of what was in there is what people would consider the low-hanging fruit, in other words, the easier stuff, so that to kind of help save us a little money. I don't know how much you can go into explaining exactly what some of those items were, but just maybe so everybody understands it.
I might ask Patty or Eric to remind me here, but I don't know that I call any of it low-hanging fruit now. And there were... Okay, this was a package of items that you couldn't pick from a menu. You were either voting for the whole thing or nothing. The first thing was around pharmacy, which is about 26% of our medical costs. One of them was to put everybody on, for maintenance drugs, put everybody on mail order for maintenance drugs. There were two programs to move people to generics before they go to specialty. Those were the pharmacy pieces. Then there was an increase in the out-of-pocket expense, maximum out-of-pockets. I don't remember ours right now, maybe $2,400. For individual versus family. The recommendation was we go to the federal Affordable Care Act standards, which are about $7,000 and $13,200. Those numbers sound alarming, but the chance that a Lewis County employee is actually going to hit those numbers is really quite rare because we have the unique benefit of having the hospital and driving a lot of our services into the hospital, which are obviously at lower or no cost. Co-pays were increased for specialty physician visits. We created a fourth tier for specialty drugs. We currently those very, very expensive drugs that a lot of us have been reading about in the news, we basically pay 100% of that cost. So we're trying to redistribute some of that. But I will say that there was something called a copay insurance plan, which even though we were going to split the cost differently with the employees would generally have the opportunity to get paid back or a reimbursement from the drug manufacturers. Eric or Patty, was there anything else? I think that was a major part of it. And then we introduced the Blue for You program. I guess it was really unfortunate that we did have 14 meetings, and that Eric and I, you know, he did the hospital, I did the county, and the union was with us. Did we capture a majority of the employees? I don't know, but we captured a significant number. I know the hospital did all three shifts. We did two shifts up at the sheriff's office. You know, it's an important issue. The union feedback I got was that the employees may not have all truly understood exactly the position we're in and, you know, what the options are going forward. The problem, and I know the union leadership understands this, is we're setting ourselves up for just double-digit premium increases going forward. And that's not a situation. The hospital, the county, employees, nobody wants to be there. So we got to figure out how to make some adjustments going forward.
Okay. I thank you for all the effort you did. I think you and Eric did a nice job meeting everybody. So, thank you.
Any other questions for Liz and Patty? Okay. I'll give you my report. Just a reminder for starters. A couple months ago, I brought an ammunition box, and I'll briefly explain it for those that weren't here or didn't hear. I attended a groundbreaking ceremony in Tompkins Park, Watertown, where they're going to build a Fort Drum monument. And at the base of this monument, they're going to have a lock and an airtight vault, ammunition boxes. They supplied three counties of ammunition boxes, Jefferson, Lewis, in St. Lawrence, and also Fort Drum in the city of Watertown. And what they're requesting is to put some mementos from your county. To date, I gotta thank Andrea, she supplied us with a couple items already. She brought a token coin from Otis, a scroll from Pine Grove Church in Watson, and along with that, I also received a bag of mini maples, but they have to be small items. But I think anything that you've got, any ideas that would kind of represent our, what makes our county what it is, thriving businesses. They'll open this thing, this monument, the base at 50 years from now. So if you've got any ideas, please come in. All right. Fred Brennan and myself attended the NYSAC conference in Lake Placid. One of the things I thought interesting was the county leaders meeting, where they asked us for topics for of our concern. And we had the NYSAC board of directors taking notes and listening, and I had the opportunity to speak right off, and I pointed out one of the complaints I heard here was the Board of Elections is looking at at least three primaries for 2016, and nothing's been done there. There's also a voter registration day that it gets very little participation, but it's state mandated. So they took note of that, and also they, Steve Aquario, the executive director from NYSAC, acknowledged that he had received a call from Senator Griffel's office, who I had called prior to the NYSAC conference. So it was right on his mind, and they're, you know, they said that it's something that they're concerned with. Other concerns that were brought up, though, were, of course, the number of counties that are faced with overriding a property tax gap. They are pretty upset with that, and, you know, different people spoke, and there was a couple of people from the governor's office present. And there was also a lot of people that expressed their disappointment with the state trying to take credit for making counties more efficient. It's been an issue with NYSAC for past year or so. They've made it a point to tell people that counties have been saving for past years. And in fact, they developed a little packet that shows where counties have saved. But yet the state still takes credit. In fact, they had a slide, they showed us that day that they said that counties are now more efficient because of the states convincing them to be consolidating. And, you know, that just riled people up more yet. I guess another priority that NYSAC will tackle is they're trying to get the state to take over the indigent defense. And so they are lobbying yet. Another meeting I attended was the joint inter-county meeting where our group, the Adirondack Inter-County, met with the Western New York group. And one of the things that we came out of that with was the UTV issue was discussed. And I gotta give someone else credit. They suggested that our county go over to Western New York to see if we can't get some support there. The Western group acknowledged that they would welcome us to attend and possibly do a resolution to support the raise to the ATV weight limit. After a little more communication, it was determined that Brian and Dick Chartrand and the St. Lawrence Trail Coordinator are going to try to make their meeting October 16th, the same day the rest of us will be going to, some of us will be going to the comptroller's office. But the purpose of that meeting will be to get them to do a resolution and to make that side of the state ask them to join our force and get a more broader approach to trying to get Albany to change the weight limit and allow registration. The final thing I have is a reminder for the inter-county meeting coming up here October 22nd. This month, Lewis County hosted and we'll be taking a tour of Mark's farm. We'll have a tour there and perhaps some discussion on the dairy industry there. And we'll move to the Boondocks where we'll host the inter-county meeting. And that's it for my report. And now we go back to our public hearing regarding the local law which would allow us to override the tax levy limit established by general municipal law for Lewis County. Does anyone at this time have any comment on our request to raise the tax cap, to override the tax cap? If not, I'll announce the public hearing is closed. To a report of the Ways and Means Committee per Rule 7. Terry.
The Ways and Means Committee reports that they've examined the claims presented for payment in the total amount of $1,915,766.31 and recommend that they be audited and allowed for the amounts claimed.
Moved by Neil, second by Brian. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Resolution carries.
The audit of claims for $1,915,766.31.
Moved by Phil, second by Larry. Roll call, Terry.
Brennan?
Yes.
Chartrand?
Yes.
Dalwell?
Yes.
Hathaway?
Yes.
King?
Yes.
Calzer?
Yes.
Marahan?
Yes.
Mosier?
Yes.
Pepper?
Yes.
Tabal?
Yes.
Local law introductory number 8 is amending local law number 6 of 2011, establishing truth in taxation of Lewis County. Resolution number 304 is setting a public hearing for that local law for November 3rd at 5 p.m.
Moved by Phil, second by Jerry. Discussion? All in favor of the resolution say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Adopting the resolution to establish or override the 2% tax cap.
Moved by Phil, second by Brian. Discussion. Again, I would point out that this does not necessarily mean we will override the tax cap. It's just a state law says we have to do it by a certain date if we have any chance that we will. Any other comments? All in favor say aye.
It's got to be a roll call.
Oh, sorry, roll call, please.
Brennan?
Yes.
Chartran?
Yes.
Dahlhoff?
Yes.
Hathaway?
Yes.
King?
Yes.
Calder?
Yes.
Mowrehan?
Yes.
Mosier?
Yes.
Pepper?
Yes.
Tabor?
Yes.
To appropriate funds, community services.
Moved by Neil, second by Dick. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Urging passage of Senate Bill 84964A and Assembly Bill 8201 by the New York State Legislature to increase the share of revenues counties retain for certain DMV services.
Moved by Larry, second by Phil. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Establishing health insurance premiums effective October 1, 2015.
Moved by Jerry, second by Brian. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Approving agreement between Highway and Solid Waste Departments with Roy Heatsworth for the internet auctions.
Moved by Craig, second by Jerry. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Designating Lewis County Chamber of Commerce as tourist promotion agency and commit matching funds.
Moved by Larry, second by Brian. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Authorizing county participation in grant wireless pilot project with Mohawk Networks and Development Authority of the North Country to expand broadband service to benefit rural communities in the North Country.
Moved by Craig, second by Jerry. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To transfer funds, Office for the Aging.
Moved by Neil, second by Brian. Discussion. Jerry.
I just had one question. I mean, I know we need it, but why are we doing such a big transfer? Are we that short in some of these line items?
Volunteers to answer? Liz?
I don't have the specifics on it, so if you want to...
That's fine. That's fine.
I can get you some information on it tomorrow, Chair.
Any other comments? All in favor of the resolution say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Appropriate funds, Office for the Aging.
Moved by Neil, second by Jerry. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To claim funds with reference to Office for the Aging.
Moved by Jerry, second by Andrea. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Amending compensation plan with reference to probation department.
Moved by Andrea, second by Brian. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Approving agreement between public health and the preschool special education program for transportation with Bernie Bus Service.
Moved by Larry, second by Jerry. Discussion.
Mr. Chairman, Andrea, is this an increase from last year or the same?
No, they actually gave us a better rate, so overall, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Other questions? All in favor of the resolution say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To appropriate funds, public health.
Moved by Brian, second by Andrea. Discussion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Number 318 has been withdrawn. 319, appropriate funds, Sheriff's Department.
Moved by Jerry, seconded by Greg. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To appropriate funds, Sheriff's Department.
Moved by Neil, seconded by Larry. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To transfer funds, Sheriff's Department.
Moved by Neil, seconded by Jerry. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
To adjust funds, Social Services.
Moved by Andrea, seconded by Brian. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Authorizing agreement between Social Services and the House of the Good Shepherd.
Moved by Larry, seconded by Neil. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Authorizing agreement between Stop DWI Foundation and Stop DWI Crackdown Program for Project Crackdown.
Moved by Jerry, seconded by Brian. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Late Resolution 325, transfer funds, Community Services, $1,700.
Moved by Neil, seconded by Andrea. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
And 26 is amending compensation with reference to Lewis County General Hospital.
Moved by Larry, seconded by Dick. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
And amending the compensation plan with reference to jail nurse.
Moved by Jerry, seconded by Neil. Discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Carried.
Approved resolutions.
Other business. Bill?
I just want to make a quick comment, Mike, and it might dovetail in with the NYSEC things you were discussing earlier. But recently, it's been in the paper that the governor is looking at offering free tuition, and nothing is ever free. And when it seems to dribble down to us quite a bit, actually. And we currently, our average for the last 7 years of community college tuition is, we're spending $836,000 a year on that alone. And I don't think we can tolerate any more. And I don't know whether we need to do a resolution to send to our representatives or do it through NYSEG or something like that. But if that program is going to get pushed, I think we need to push back on it so we don't get the tail end of it again.
No, if it's not too late, Phil, at our inter-county meeting, I also invited our regional representative from the governor's office, Jeff Farrell, so that might be a perfect place to bring it up for discussion if you want to wait that long.
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, good point.
Yeah, what's the date?
You got it.
20 seconds.
What's that?
You have to remember to ask it, though. We won't forget by then.
Who will forget? 20 seconds.
When it comes to money, I don't usually forget.
Sure. October 22nd, 10:30. Yeah, we meet at Mark's Farm, and then we boondocks probably noon or 12:30.
Okay.
But we'll have our official intercounty meeting as boondocks.
Mr. Chairman, might it be appropriate to send a quick letter to him so that he can prepare himself for a correct answer?
Or otherwise.
I'm on the phone with him frequently, so I can call him.
Actually, Neil just made a good suggestion, too. When we get on to the controller's office, we should bring it up with them as well.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Good question, though.
Does anyone have any other business before we do proclamations? Okay, Terry, would you give us the proclamations?
Breast Cancer Awareness Month, whereas breast cancer is the most common cause of cancer and the second leading cause of cancer deaths among women in New York State, and about 1 in 8 women will develop breast cancer during their lifetime. Lives can be saved when breast cancer is found early, when treatment is most effective. The country celebrates with 2.5 million breast cancer survivors while recognizing that breast cancer deaths are declining due to early detection. Lewis County Public Health joins the national initiative in the fight against breast cancer with energy, devotion, and compassion on the local front. And now, therefore, I, Michael A. Tabal, Chairman of the Board of Legislature, do hereby proclaim the month of October as Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and encourage all citizens to join in the fight by promoting breast health awareness and the efforts to find a cure for breast cancer. We also have declaring October 18th through the 24th as Freedom from Workplace Bullies Week. The County of Lewis has an interest in promoting the social and economic well-being of its employees and citizens. Their well-being depends upon the existence of healthy and productive employees working in safe and abuse-free environments. Surveys and studies have documented the stress-related health and consequences for individuals caused by exposure to abusive work environments. Abusive work environments can create costly consequences for employers, including reduced productivity, absenteeism, turnover, employee health-related expenses, and if left unchecked, costly litigation. Protection from abusive work environments should apply to every worker and not be limited to a legally protected class status based upon a race, color, gender, national origin, age, or disability. Now, therefore, on behalf of the Board of Legislators, I, Michael A. Tabal, proclaim October 18 to 24 as Freedom from Workplace Bullies Week. Proclaiming Lead Poisoning Prevention Week for the week of October 25 to the 31st. The theme is Lead Free Kids for a Healthy Future. Nearly 500,000 children living in the United States have elevated lead levels that may cause significant damage to their health, estimates the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Children can develop behavior and learning problems such as hyperactivity, slow growth, hearing problems, and aggressive patterns of behavior. Major sources of lead exposure to U.S. children include lead-based paint and lead-contaminated dust in deteriorating buildings. Children can also be exposed to lead from additional sources, including contaminated drinking water, take-home exposures from a workplace, and lead in the soil. Despite the continued presence of lead in the environment, lead poisoning is entirely preventable. Stopping a child's exposure to lead from leaded paint, house dust, or any other source is the best way to prevent the harmful effects of lead. The chairman has declared the week of October 25 to the 31st as National Lead Poisoning Prevention Week. And in Lewis County, calls upon the people to observe this month by helping our families, friends, neighbors, and leaders better understand the importance of public health's efforts to decrease the most preventable disease among young children by raising awareness about lead poisoning.
Yeah. Thank you, Terry. Now, we do have numerous topics for executive session with contract negotiations, contract discussion, and personnel issue. Do we have a motion to go into executive session at this time? Brian, second by Craig. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We are in executive session. We'll have a 5-minute recess.